Your router can do a lot more than hand out Wi-Fi. In a few minutes, it can become the most powerful privacy tool that you own. And most people have no idea it's even there. Your router already connects everything in your home, which makes it the perfect place to install a VPN. Once it's set up, every phone, TV, and console on your Wi-Fi stays protected automatically. You don't have to think about extra apps or device limits ever again, since using a VPN on your router only counts as one device. But before we begin, a quick check. If your router came from your internet provider, it probably can't run a VPN. Routers from ASUS, TP-Link, Netgear, or Linksys usually can. And if you're using a mesh system like Google Nest or Eero, then you'll need a second VPN-ready router or ExpressVPN's pre-flashed model instead. So in this video, I'll show you how to install ExpressVPN on your router step-by-step, check compatibility, get the setup files, and confirm it's all working by the end. Welcome back to VPN Mentor, where we make online privacy simple and actually useful. So now that you've got a rough idea of where your router stands, let's confirm it properly. Flip your router over and look for the model number. Type that model number into a quick search along with the words VPN client supports. If you see OpenVPN or VPN clients mentioned anywhere in that search, then that means that your router can probably handle this setup. If it doesn't support VPNs, don't worry, you still have other options. You can get a secondary router that does support VPNs, or even easier, buy a pre-configured ExpressVPN router that's ready out of the box. Technically, you can flash custom firmware like DTWRT or OpenWRT to make an unsupported router work, but I only recommend going down that path if you're comfortable doing so, as one wrong file can permanently disable your entire router, and recovery isn't always easy. If you're using a second router behind the one from your internet provider, check if that first box can be switched to bridge mode. Sometimes calling your internet provider is the easiest way to find out. Using bridge mode prevents potential double-NAT issues and keeps the VPN connection stable. Once you know your router's compatible, you can move straight into setup. Okay, here's what you'll need before we dive in. For this example, we'll use ExpressVPN. So the first thing you obviously need is an active ExpressVPN subscription. Second, a VPN compatible router. I'll be using an ASUS router for this example, but these steps work almost the same for most brands. And third, you'll need a computer connected to that router, preferably with a cable so nothing drops midway. And that's it. You don't need any extra gadgets or complex software. Everything happens right inside your web browser. So step one is to log into your router. Start by opening your browser on the computer that's connected to your router. In the address bar, type your router's IP address, and for most routers, that's 192.168.1.1 or 192.168.0.1. Still, I recommend checking the sticker under it, as the IP address is usually there too. Now, if you're using an ASUS router, you can simply type router.asus.com, and that'll open your router's login page. If you've never changed your credentials, check the sticker on the back or bottom of your router, and the default username and password are usually listed there. All right, next we're gonna go ahead and log in. So once you're inside, you're looking at the control panel that runs your entire network. It might look different depending on your brand, but the structure is similar for all major routers. Also, a quick security note: if your router still uses the default admin password, change it after this setup. It's one of the easiest ways that hackers can sneak into your home network, so definitely change that. All right, step two is get your ExpressVPN configuration files. Now that you're inside your router's settings, open a new browser tab and head to expressvpn.com and sign in here using the email and password that you used when you subscribed. Once you're in, go to Setup Other Devices, then click Manual Configuration. Choose OpenVPN from the options, and that's the most secure and widely supported setup for routers. Then on this page, you'll see your OpenVPN username and password at the top and a list of server configuration files below. Each file represents a different VPN location, so pick the one that you want to connect to, say New York or London, and download that file to your computer. Keep it somewhere easy to find because you'll be uploading it into your router next. That's it for this step. You've just grabbed the key details that your router needs to talk directly to ExpressVPN's network. So step three is to add the VPN profile to your router. So now head back to your router's dashboard, and on the left side, look for the VPN section. If you're using an ASUS router, you'll see it right in the sidebar. Click VPN client, then choose add profile and select OpenVPN. Now give this profile a quick name so you can recognize it later. Something like ExpressVPN New York works perfectly fine. Then paste the username and password that you copied from the ExpressVPN setup page. After that, upload the configuration file you downloaded earlier. Once everything's in place, click import.ovpn file, or upload depending on your router, then OK, and finally activate. Wait a few seconds, and then when it connects, you'll see a green checkmark or a message that says connected. That means that every device on your Wi-Fi is now routing through ExpressVPN automatically. Now, step four, and this is a really important one, is to test your VPN connection. Now that your router's connected, let's actually make sure that it's really working. Open a browser on any device that's connected to your Wi-Fi and visit whatismyipaddress.com or expressvpn.com/what-is-my-ip. If your VPN is set up correctly, you'll see the location of the server that you picked, maybe New York, London, or wherever you chose. And that should hopefully be different than your real city. If you're connected but can't load websites, then check your router's DNS is set to automatic or to ExpressVPN's DNS under the WAN or Internet tab. That usually fixes this issue. If it still shows your actual location, don't panic. Try deactivating and reactivating the profile first. If that doesn't fix it, restart your router and test it again. In most cases, it connects properly once it restarts. Once this is working, everything on your Wi-Fi network is now automatically covered by ExpressVPN. That's one setup protecting your entire home network, which is pretty awesome. Step five is the ExpressVPN router firmware. If your router supports it, there's an even easier way to manage all of this. ExpressVPN offers its own custom firmware that replaces your router's regular control panel with a much easier one built from the ground up for VPN use. With it, you can switch between servers in seconds, see which devices are connected, and even decide which ones should use the VPN and which ones shouldn't. For example, you could keep your smart TV connected through ExpressVPN for streaming, while your work laptop stays on the regular connection. This version of ExpressVPN firmware also runs on the lightweight protocol by default, which gives you faster speeds and quicker reconnects compared to OpenVPN. To check if your router is compatible, visit expressvpn.com/setup and look under the router section. If your model is listed here, then you can download the firmware and follow the guided installer right from this page. The interface is going to walk you through the entire process so you don't have to dig through advanced settings or import files manually. That brings us to step six, however, which is, what if your router doesn't support VPNs? If your router doesn't have VPN options anywhere in its settings, don't worry, because you still have a few simple ways that you can make this work. The easiest option is to buy a pre-configured ExpressVPN router. These come ready to go with the VPN already installed, so you just log in and choose your server. It's plug and play with no need for flashing or file uploads. The second option is to use ExpressVPN's MediaStreamer feature. It isn't a VPN, but it changes your DNS so you can unblock services like Netflix or Hulu on devices that don't normally support VPN apps like smart TVs or gaming consoles. You'll find the setup instructions for that in your ExpressVPN account as well if you're interested in it. And finally, if you like a little DIY, you can create a virtual router using your computer. That turns your PC or Mac into a Wi-Fi hotspot and shares your VPN connection with other devices. It's definitely not as elegant as a dedicated router, but it does get the job done if you're on a budget or just testing things out. So even if your current router isn't compatible, you've still got plenty of solid backup options. Now, once your VPN is set up and running, there's a few small tweaks that can make a big difference in performance. First, if you ever notice slower speeds, try connecting to a server that's physically closer to you. The shorter the distance, the faster the connection usually is. Next, make sure your router's firmware is up to date. Outdated firmware can cause random drops or slowdowns even when your VPN is working just fine. Now, if you're streaming or gaming, you can also test ExpressVPN's lightweight protocol inside the router app or firmware. It's designed to keep speeds high and maintain stable connections, especially if you have a lot of devices devices online at once. And one more tip, if you ever lose internet access after activating the VPN, just deactivate the profile, check your login credentials, and reconnect. In most cases, this is just a temporary handshake issue. But that's pretty much it. Your router is now running ExpressVPN, which means everything connected to your Wi-Fi is automatically protected. The setup locks down your entire network, keeps your data private, and even lets you access content from anywhere in the world. If you're planning to upgrade or want to compare options, then be sure to check out our updated guide on the best VPNs for routers specifically. It covers tested models, speed results, and reliable alternatives to ExpressVPN. You can check that out using the link down below, but if you found this video to be helpful, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to VPN Mentor, and I'll see you in the next video.